Welcome to this demonstration on visual log feature in ZTPFGI suite. This is a very handy feature that allows you to maintain an audit trail of the work done. This is the simplest and easiest way to ensure that you don't lose any of your valuable ideas and allows you to quickly recover from any mistakes that's been made while debugging. Also, it allows you to show others what you have done through screen captures. The screen captures visually captures the ZTPFGI windows and the events that are happening in the ZTPFGI suite, like the ECB activity, trace output, the input-output messages and error messages. The benefits out of this log feature is that it helps you to maintain a full audit trail of the work done, which provides or leads to better scoping and transparency. And it provides you to the ability to easily capture and share with others the work performed. This improves your or aids in your debug. Now that we have seen briefly of what the visual log feature is, now let's move on to see the preference options for using this visual log feature. That is the options that's been defined for using the visual log feature. You know, ZTPF options is the dialog is where we change our preference settings. So this visual log is grouped under the analysis tool. So once you click on it, the default options, preference options for this feature is shown. And here the directory path for storing a visual log is defined, and it's path directs you to the My Documents of your PC, and the size of this windows cap of the screen captures is being defaulted to 800 pixels. You can change them if required. The screen, if you want to visual log any of these events, you can check on the respective checkboxes. You can select more than one checkbox at here, and now I don't want to capture any of this event, so I'm not checking on any of these events as of now. I'm clicking OK to confirm my visual log options settings. So the next step would be to use this visual log feature. You could see here this feature can be accessed from the analysis tab in your from your main ribbon menu. And until I turn on this visual log options, the screen captures, the commands and display will remain disabled. This is a toggle button, but I can turn it on by single click, and again I can turn it off via clicking it again. This option can be used even without getting yourself connected to any available test system. So I'm going to turn this option. So a new visual log opens. I'm going to just leave it as analysis. Have this checkbox enabled because I want to create a zip file, a folder for of all the visual log files that's been collected for this session. If you uncheck this box, only a folder containing visual log files will be available. Only if you check this box, once you close this log, a zip folder of the visual logs will be created in your My Documents path or to the any path that you defined in your as your base directory path. I'm clicking OK to confirm my name. So you could see all the capture options, command and display are now enabled. This capture is an all-in-one capture that captures images for the visual log. So all the tabs, windows that are currently active in my window can be captured. So just click on the project to take a snapshot of the project. Click on the host files view to get host files view, and click on the job status to take a snapshot of the job status, and that's how it goes. Click on this comment to add any comment that you want to. You can add individual comment to each of the visual log file. You can say pre-analysis done. You could see a note styling is applied to your text that's been keyed in. So if you want to apply any style to your text and it want you to make it more presentable, click on this checkbox that puts you in a mono space font with no word wrap. So this is the preference that can be set based on the users. So I'm checking this option and clicking OK to confirm it. So all the comments would now be available in a presentable format in a monospace font. Click on this browse button to view your visual logs. So this is the folder, this is the we have given for this visual log folder. So all the visual logs will be available under this, and you could see any capture, all the capture that I've done will be available as a PNG image, and this HTML will capture all the XML image, will give me the consolidated list of all the visual logs that are available. Okay, and click on this options to direct you directly to the visual log options to make your preference, change to your preference settings if required. You want to make any changes now, so I'm clicking cancel. And now that we have captured the visual log, now we have come to an end of this things. We have to now turn it off to create the zip folder. I'm going to click again, so it a dialog box opens where it says you are about to close the visual log, would you like to continue or not? And you can check this box if you don't want to ask this question again. I would like to get this alert, so I'm not checking this box. I'm going to click OK to turn off my visual log options. And if you go and click this browse button now, we could see that the analysis zip, it's been created. So that's all in terms of visual log feature. Thank you.